7 storm track weather with meteorologist Max Zaparis.
Hi everyone, starting off with Doppler radar where we're tracking some showers and storms already in southern Wisconsin. We're in Rock County now up towards Milton. We have some showers and some lightning strikes there. And down towards Afton and Beloit, heads up Beloit, you're going to be seeing this head your way in the next 15 minutes or so. Farther north, widespread rain through Jefferson County up towards Dodge County too on the east side of the county out towards Hustisford. And this is all shifting eastward. Meanwhile, a few more showers and storms as we look northward towards Nisida and westward into Juneau County. A couple more down I-94 outside of the viewing area. Big picture, you can see we're in a little bit of a break, all things considered, after seeing widespread rain last night. And there's more widespread rain to go that's developing down to the south over southern Iowa and northern Missouri. Let's track that out for you. Next couple of hours, just a spotty shower and storm chance through around 3 o'clock. Then we're going to see that wave move in that could bring us more widespread chances by the evening commute and dinner time. So definitely have the headlights on when driving home today if you're coming across that rain. Still looks like widespread rain by 8 in the evening, especially for our central and eastern areas, so really along and east of I-39, going to be favored for the particularly heavy rainfall that could lead to some flooding. And all this is out of here before midnight. How much rain am I anticipating? Another 10th to a half inch for most spots. But look into the east side of the viewing area and into southeastern Wisconsin. An inch to 2 inches, not out of the question. And because of that, we have a flood threat. This afternoon and evening, areas in yellow under a level 2 slight risk for severe, for some heavy rain to cause that flood threat, as hot spots could get up to 2 inches. So low-lying spots could see some standing water. Of course, never enter into any of those flooded areas. And we don't need more rain. The ground is already pretty wet, so we can't handle more on top of what we've already gotten. Lone Rock, since yesterday evening, nearly 3.5 inches of rain. Muscadet under 2 inches with Sauk City. Baraboo at 1.5 inches with DeSoto. Boscobel at 1.25 inches. Under 1 inch in Camp Douglas and Partyville in Madison. We're at around 0.9 inches so far. And again, we're going to get more on top of what we've already gotten. Temps are rain cooled because of all the clouds sticking around today and the fact that we got that wave of rain this morning in the upper 60s to around 70. Warm spot is Watertown and Platteville tied at 73. Meanwhile, 66 in Baraboo, 66 in Camp Douglas. You can see we're kind of right on top of the front. Winds coming out of the north for our northern areas, cooling you off a little bit more. So we have a little flow out of the south, and right where those winds meet is where we have that front, and that front's going to guide more rain our direction, but keep us rather cool. I think high is going to get to the mid and upper 70s later today, and that's about it. Farther to the north, you'll likely stay stuck in the upper 60s and low 70s. So certainly a cooler day ahead. 78 degrees today with scattered showers and storms, especially later this afternoon and evening. That 78 might even be a little too high. Either way, much cooler than the last several days, though we heat back up in your 7-day forecast. Before that, tonight 65 with the rain tapering off before midnight. Then we get patchy fog pre-dawn Thursday. Mid 80s by Thursday afternoon with a sun-cloud mix and just the potential for a pop-up shower storm here and there. Nowhere near as widespread as today. Your 7-day forecast nearing 90 on Friday with lots of humidity and plenty of heat. Low 90s this weekend with just an isolated storm chance. And as of now, it looks like the majority of the rain this weekend is going to fall actually over the in the overnight hours with a complex of storm systems. But just stay tuned. We have to update the forecast as we get a little bit closer. Either way, today certainly looking rather wet,
yeah.
Especially if you're in Madison and points south and east. That's where we're going to be favored with the heaviest rain totals.
Yeah, rain boots, umbrella, need it all today.
Stick around, yeah.
Max, thank you.